Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. You all know the division by normal method, right? When they given a dividend and divisor, we all know how to find the remainder and quotient. Now the same division we will do it in a Vedic math method. So first problem, 160 divided by 9. Clear? So usually you can do in a traditional method. Now we can do the same problem in Vedic math, right? Okay. So in a, when you are using a Vedic math, within the fraction of second, you will get the answer, right? The same thing. Now, right, the 160 is a divide and the 9 is a divisor, right? So write the dividend 160. So between the digits, you leave some space, right? Next, draw the line and one horizontal line also, right? Clear? Next, write the divisor. Here, what is the divisor here? 9. So write the 9 here. Clear? Now here the divisor is only one digit. So in dividend, you just split the number by one digit, right? Clear? Actually the divisor is 9. There is only one digit. So we are dividing, that is splitting a number by one digit, right? Okay. Next. Now the 9 is closer to 10. The 9 is closer to 10. How much I supposed to add with 9, it became a 10, that is a 1. So you can write a 1 here. Clear? Actually, 9 is closer to 10. So what number I supposed to add with 9, it became a 10, that is 1. So I just write it 1 here. Clear? Okay. That is called as the base number. The 10 is called as the base number. Okay. Now, as usual, down the number 1 as it is. What it is given? Down the number 1. First number. Now, you just multiply 1 into 1, this one into here. So, 1 ones are 1. You can write the answer here. 1 ones are 1. Now, you can add this 6 plus 1, 7. Continue the same process. 7 into 1. 7 into 1, 7. Right, you can add it 0 plus 7, 7. Clear? Here, you come to the process. The last column, we get a last column answer. The 7 is a remain 1 and 7. So 1, 7 is a quotient. Are you all clear? Any more doubt? Clear? Sure, okay. We can go with the one more example. Second one. 112 divided by 9. Clear? Now the same thing. Write the divided 4, 112 and leave the space between the digits. Then draw the line, vertical line as well as a horizontal line. Now you can write that divisor here 9. The same thing, 9 is closer to the base number. Base number is 10 here. So what number is supposed to add 9 became a 10? That is 1. You should write a 1 here. Clear? Then the divisor is 9. That is a single digit. So you can split the dividend by 1 more digits. Right? Clear? Now as usual, first step you just down the 4 as it is. What is given in the first number? As it is, you can down it. 4. Now, you should multiply 1 into 4. 1 into 4? 4. So, you can add a 1 plus 4. That is 5. The same number. You can multiply again. 1 into 5? 5. So, 7. So, the last number is a, we don't know what it is. Remainder. Then, 45. It's a quotient. Have you all clear? Any more doubt? Sure, okay. We can go with the one more example. The same card. 203rd question. 236 divided by 7. 236 by 7. Here we are dividing by one digit number. We can go with the two digit and three digit, four digit also, right? The same procedure. What is the following for one digit? The same thing for two digit. Same thing for three digit also, right? Okay, now. Right, 336, as usual, divisor is 7 here. Now, the same thing, 7 is closer to the 10, closer to the 10, the base number is 10. So, what number is supposed to add, it became a 10, that is 3. So, you can write a 3 here. Now, you just divide the digits, because the divisor is single digit, so we are dividing by single digit. If suppose the 2 digit number is a divisor, you can pair by 2, 2. Clear? Okay. Now, down the number 2 as it is. Now, multiply 2 into 3, 2 into 3, 6. So 3 plus 6, it became a 9. Again, you should multiply. 3 9s are 27. Write the 27, add it here, it became a 33. Clear? Listen, in this problem, the divisor is greater than the remainder. But here, the remainder is greater than the divisor. Clear? Always keep in our mind, we'll get a remainder is less than the divisor. But it is here more than. So what you're supposed to do, you can take the remainder and continue the process. You just divide the remainder by 7 again. Clear? So the previous problem is get directly the remainder. But okay, the remainder is more than the 7. So what you're supposed to do, again you should do the process. So you can divide the remainder divided by the divisor. Right? The same procedure. 3, 3. Here 7. So how much it is more? 3. So now, down the first number, 3. 3, 3 is a 9. Here, 9 plus 3, it became 12. Again, the 12 also more than the 7. Again, continue the same process. 1, 2. Here 7, 3. Down the first number 1, 1, 3 is a 3, then 5. Now the remainder is 5. It is less than the 7, so we can stop the problem. Now, we can write the quotient. So the remainder is last one. What is the remainder? Remainder, you should take a last value. What it is? 5. 5 is a remainder. Quotient. Quotient is equal to, here we get a 29 is a quotient, right? So you can write a 29. So next step, we get a quotient 3. Last step, we get a quotient 1. You can add together. What it is? 33. So quotient is 33. Remainder is 5. Are you all clear? Now we can go with the one more example. Problem number 4. That is 754 divided by 8. Clear? Clear? Okay. Now, as usual, you can write it. 7, 5, 4. The line. Horizontal line and vertical line. Then, divisor 8. You can split the number by 1 digits. Next step. How much is supposed to add? It became a 10? 2. So, you can write a 2 here. Now, down the first number as it is, 7. Now, 7 2, so I can multiply 2 value. 7 2 is a 14. So write a 14. 5 plus 14 became a 19. Right? Now, 19 into 2. What it is? 38. Now, we can add it. 42. Clear? Again, the remainder is more than the divisor. The remainder is more than the divisor. So continue the process again. What it is? The same one. 42. Divisor 8. We can write a 2 here. Right? So split it by 2 parts. Now down the 4 as it is. 4 to the 8. Now here 10. Again the 10 also it is more than the 8. So continue the process again. Here 1, 0, 8. Here 2. Divide the number 2 parts. Now down the first number 1, 1 2 is a 2, 0 plus 2, 2. So we can fix the value, the remainder is 2. So we can write, remainder is equal to 2. Then the quotient. Quotient is equal to, here we get a quotient, what it is? 7, then here 1, 9. Listen, you can keep it in your mind. Here we can capture only one digit. We will get the answer also in one digit, but here it is a two digit. So we can give this one, 19, here you can give the 1, this 1 is the tens place, you can give the 1s to the tens place value. Here tens place is 7, so you can add a 7 plus 1, 8, 89. Clear? Plus, here 4, plus, here what is the quotient? 1. So we can add all together, it became a 94. So the quotient is 94, the remainder is 2. Clear? Any more doubt? Okay, up to the fourth problem, we have used that the divisor as a single digit. Now, problem number 5, we can go with a 2-digit number. The divisor is a 2-digit. Now, 4 not 4, that is 404, divide 98, right? Very easiest one. The same procedure what we did for single-digit divisor, the same thing for 2-digit divisor. You can write it, 4 not 4 as usual, divide and then divisor 98. Now you can split the number by 2, right? Because the 2 digit number is the divisor. So here you can pair the number back side onwards, right? So 0, 4, 1 pair, again 4, remain, that's all. Now this 98 is closer to 100, that is the base number is 100 here, right? It is closer to 100. So how much is supposed to add with 98 became 100? 2. So write a 2 here. Then as usual, down the first number, 4. 4 2s are 8. Then you can add it, what it is? 12. So here, the 12 is less than the 98. So we can fix it. 12 is a reminder. Then 4 is a quotient. Clear? Okay, we can go to one more example. 6 to 1. It's actually 83,95,672 divides 98. So now we can write it. Divide it as 83,95,672. What is the divisor here? 98. Clear? Now you can pair the number by 2. Right? Because it's a 2 digit divisor. Clear? Okay. Now it is closer to 100. So you can write 2 here. Clear? Now as it is down the first number 8 here. 8. 8 2s are 16. Now you can add it. 16 plus 39. 9 plus here 50. 5. Became a 55. Now we can multiply 55 into 2, it became a 2, it is 110, right? Now we can add it, it became a 140. We are adding 56 plus 110, it became a 166. Now we can multiply 166 into 2, it became a 6 2s are 2, remaining 1, 6 2s are 2, 2 plus 1, 3, next 1 2s are 2. So 2 plus 1, 3. So 332 is the answer, right? Clear? Now you can add it. 4 here 7 plus 0, 1 4. So 404, right? So again you should continue the same process, 404, right? That is the reminder is more than the divisor. So 404, 98. We did it in the last problem, right? Now, as usual, pair the number down the 4. Here 2, 2 4s are 8. So 12. So what is the reminder? So reminder is 12. So you can write first reminder equal to 12. Next quotient. Quotient is equal to here every number I gave here 2 number. So down also you'll get the answer also in a 2 digit, right? But here it is 166. You can take a 66 alone. 6. 1 you can leave the number here, it is 100th place, so you can leave the 100th place to the next block. So 55 plus 1, 56. Next, 8. Next, here 1 quotient, plus 4. Now we can add it, became a 0, 7, 6, 5, 8. What it is actually? 0, then 0, 7, 6, 5, 8 is the answer. That is a quotient. 85,970 is the answer. Right? Are you all clear? Can go with one more example? Yes. Okay. Up to the 6th problem. The 6th problem, we used the divisor as a 2 digit number. Now we can go with a 3 digit number, right? So the problem is 42,301 divides 996. So right, 42,301 996. And now we can split the number by 33 because the divisor is 3 digit number. So we can pair by 33. Yeah. Then as usual, down the first number, what it is? 42. Now, here how much is supposed to add? It became a base number. Here base number is 1000. So what supposed to add? 4. So 4 2s are 8. 4 4s are 16. Now you can add it. It became a 9, 6, 4. So 469, it is less than the divisor, so we can fix it as a remainder. So it is a remainder. 42 is equal to quotient. Are you all clear? Any more doubt? Chalo, okay. Then go with the one more example. 93,000 and 8th problem. 3,678 divided by 991. As usual. Right? 9391. As usual. By the divided 93678. Then divide up 991. So how much it is closer to the base number? Here the base number is 1000. So when what number I supposed to add, it became 1000. That is 9, right? You can write a 9 here. Now pair the number by 33 because it's a 3-digit number. Right, clear. So 96 into 9. We should multiply this two value and write here, right? So 93s are 27. 7 remaining 2, 99s are 81 plus 2, 83. Clear? Now you can add it. Here it is 15, 1, so 4 plus 11, remaining 1, so again here it is 15. So now the remainder is greater than the divisor. So what are you supposed to do? Again you should continue the process, right? 1, 5, 1, 5. What is the number? 991, 9. Clear? Now we can pair the number by 33. Now the number 1, 1 9s are 9. Now we can add a 9 with 5, 15. It became 14. Remaining 1. So 1. It is 2, 5. So 524 is a remainder. It is less than the divisor. So you can fix it as a remainder. But quotient is equal to, what is this quotient here? Quotient is equal to, here you have a quotient, what it is? 93, second one, plus 1, became a 94. The quotient is 94. Clear? Any more doubt in this? Okay. So up to problem number 8, we have discussed up to the 3-digit divisor. Now we can go with the 4-digit divisor. The problem is 39,854 divides 9,989, right? As usual, same process. You can do it. 39,854. Then the symbol, then write a divisor 9,989. Clear? Now we can split the dividend by 4 terms, right? 4 digits. Yeah, check out. Now, what number is supposed to add became a base number? Here the base number is 10,000. So here you can add with 11, it became a base number, right? Check, okay. Now, as usual, down the first number 3, multiply 3 into 11, 33. So now you can add it, 7, 8, 8, 9. So here the remainder is less than the divisor. So fix it as a remainder. What is the quotient here? Quotient is equal to 3. Clear? Anyone know? Okay. We can go with one more example. Problem number 10. Last problem. 85,743 divides 9,899. Now it is closer to 10,000. How much I add supposed to it became a 10,000? Here 102. So 201. Clear? Okay. Now pair the number by 4 digits. Down the number 8 as it is. Now 8 ones are 8, 800, 8 twos are 16. You can add it. 11, 1 remaining here, 5. 13 remaining 1, so 7, yes. So now the remainder is 7000, but the divisor is 9000, so it is less than the remainder. less than the divisor. So we can write it as a remainder. What is the quotient? 8. So quotient is equal to 8. Clear? Any more doubt? Hope in this video you make clear about the basic math division. And next video you can go with the one more basic trick. Thank all of you.